In this illustration, we'll analyze a rocket moving in gravity-free space. Here we are given that a rocket starts moving from rest in a space in absence of external forces by ejecting gases from a steady jet at constant velocity u relative to rocket. We are required to find the velocity of rocket when its mass is m, and it is also given that initial mass of rocket is m naught and ejection rate of gases from the jet is r. Here we solve the problem by the conventional method of using momentum conservation at an intermediate time t and t plus dt. Here we can consider if this is the rocket from which gases are ejecting out, and say at any instant it is moving with a velocity v, and say its mass is m. The very next moment, say if this time is t, then we can analyze it at time t plus dt, when the rocket would be moving with the velocity v plus dv. Its mass reduces to m minus dm, and the mass dm of gases which eject out will be at a speed u relative to rocket, so the speed would be u minus v plus dv. Now, in this situation, we conserve momentum at time t and t plus dt as, here you can see initial momentum of rocket was mv at time t, and at time t plus dt, the momentum of rocket is m minus dm multiplied by v plus dv minus the momentum of ejected gases, that is dm multiplied by u minus v minus dv. If we open this equation, this is mv is equals to, this gives mv minus dmv plus mdv, we can neglect dmdv, the product of elemental quantities, minus this dmu plus dmv, again we can neglect the product of elemental quantities. Here this mv gets cancelled out, and you can see this dmv also gets cancelled out. So the relation we are having is mdv is equals to udm. So here we can write dv is equals to u dm by m, and further if we integrate this expression, when speed was 0, mass of rocket was m naught, when it reduces to m, the speed increases to v. So this gives us v is equals to u ln of m by m naught. In this situation, here you can see this result is negative. So here you can see, as dm is the mass which is ejecting out from rocket, so here we have to introduce a negative sign, where we can write negative sign is introduced as dm is negative, because here you can see the mass of rocket is continuously decreasing, but here velocity is increasing. So to hold the homogeneity on the two sides of equality, it has to be taken negative. So if we introduce a negative sign here, the result will be u ln of m naught by m. So this will be the final result of the problem.